Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK. And aren't we lucky? We live in an age when you haven't got to spend thousands of pounds on a big Fender bass rig to sound good. It's not back in the day, it's now, 2019. You can get some amazing amplifiers to gig with in the home, in the studio, versatile little things for not a lot of money. And I have the pleasure today to talk you through some of my favorites. Here are six cheap bass amps that don't suck. These aren't all cheap small bass amps for the house. Some of them are cheap ones that you could gig with, so they're a little bit more expensive, they're not all dirt cheap. Some of them are nice and versatile, like this little LT25, which I'll get to in a moment. Some of them are big and lovely, like the Ashdowns I'll get to shortly. We've also got offerings from Orange and Blackstar. Guitar and setup wise, I'm using this beautiful new Squire Classic Vibe 60s. It's one of the new ones with a tint neck jazz bass, cracking all two Tech cables into the gorgeous Aston Stealth microphone. So, without further ado, let's get started with this little handsome bugger to the left of me. This is the Fender Rumble LT25. It says on Fender's site that they've been making the most perfect amps for years, and I wholeheartedly agree. Fender amps are amazing, whether they're acoustic amps, electric amps, or bass amps. Those old Fender bass ones, man, those lovely valve things, sound so good. And you can get those sounds. If you're on a little bit of a budget, well, you haven't got thousands of pounds to spend, and you want to play them in your living room or bedroom. The LT25 is a small little 25-watt powerhouse with 30 built-in presets. The Rumbles have always been popular. They had the old ones, the big ones that were covered in carpet. And a few years ago, they bought these new ones. Very lightweight, very portable, and very loud. 25 watts, it's got an 8-inch speaker in it, and it's ported to get that lovely bass low end out, even though it's small. Sorry, I talked about the Rumbles before, wasn't I? Yeah, Rumbles have been out for years, great things. This one now has incorporated the new Mustang technology, the new Fender Mustangs, where there's presets built in, there's effects built in. It's amazing. There's 30 presets from factory. There's actually 50, which I'll get to in a moment about how you change. Top, very simple. Gain, 3-band EQ and a volume. I know I'm talking very fast, but I want to get through this so you can hear what it sounds like. Auxiliary in, so you can play along with your backing tracks. Headphone out, so you can play with the speakers muted and just through your headphones. A little USB input, because they're constantly updating the firmware on this to make it sound better and better for all you lovely folk. Simple as that, really. There's a couple of buttons, which I'll get to in a mo. But let's hear it some more. This was the first preset. That one was called Studio Clean. Cracking things for the next one. Studio Squeeze, so a little bit of compression on. There's 20 effects in this bad lad. Not all compression and bass bulk effects. There's distortions, modulations, delays, and reverbs. And they're all kind of in the presets that come with it. You can't tweak them though. All you do is press the edit. It's all literally labeled on the top as well. They make it super simple. It's like the really good Fisher Price Fender bass amp. So you click it and you see a little screen, little LED screen, really, really nice. And you scroll through your amp, your stomp boxes, modulations, EQs, and delays, and just simply tap and click away until you find the one which is good. If you can add distortion, add delay, everything, and make it very, very easy. And the little buttons at the side simply say back, in case you've gone to a place you don't know how to turn back from. Save to save your new preset on top of the preset that's already there. When you've affected a preset that it comes with, the screen goes red as opposed to blue. So it shows you that it's been affected. There's a menu, which goes to the global menu, and a tap tempo for the delays and reverbs. And if you hold it down, you get a very accurate tuner, which is great for bass, because a lot of like multi-effect amps and modeling amps do kind of suck for bass, but this one's great. But I'm not gonna mess with any of that now. I'm just gonna go through the factory presets as you would in a lovely PMT store and show you what they sound like, because they're great. So that was two, Studio Squeeze. Number three is Rumble. Rumble's always had a lot of low end, whether it be the old carpety ones, or the new ones. They just kind of brought that forward to the 21st century. Three, electric upright. Electric spelt with two K's as well. Does that mean it's kind of like an upright bass? Like, dirty rock bass. I'm not going to go through all of them, just maybe 10 or so to show you how versatile it is. Dirty rock bass. And obviously all these presets, you can make your own or add whatever you want, and if you add a bit of chorus onto that. Fat old bassman. Nice. Oh, organ tone. So some of the modulation tones are awesome. You can sound like this. How cool is that? Slap bass, number eight. I suck at slap bass, so this will be very short and sweet. Everything you could possibly want in a little portable bass amp. And this is well under £200. Flanger bass. When you see a flanger, you've got to go. These little guys are awesome. So I would say it comes with 30 presets built in, but there's actually 50. They didn't want to give it 50 banks for some reason. It's a lot of banks. So what you can do is, out of the ones, well, you just tap edit, like I said before, and scroll down to replace. Click it and you can replace it with any other of the hidden 20 presets that come with it. Sounds a bit complicated, but the buttons are so easy to do and the manual is very easy to read. They make it simple for people like me to explain to you, who are obviously a bit more intelligent than me. 70s rock. Fat bottom. That is one hell of a fat bottom. Very woofy, very nice. It's so small as well, man. It's reassuringly heavy as well. You don't want to be too light. The rumbles are supposed to be light. This one's heavy because you don't want it rattling away. With a lot of low end, you don't want it rattling. You don't want it to be flimsy. It's reassuringly heavy. It's very good. Not as heavy as the old ones. They were rad. It's called Monster Bot. Big echo. Very nice, definitely a big echo there. Auto wah. Very nice, they managed to fit a lot in this little guy. Oh, I've got to end on something like this. Chorus basses sound fantastic. And Fender do effects, bass amps, and amplifiers very good. Very versatile, very small. I'll leave you with this. This is the Ashdown AAA 60-10T. 60 watts, 10-inch speaker, perfect for the home or stage. A lot of the AAA stuff by Ashdown is great for home or stage. This one particularly because it's the smallest, I believe, with a DI out. 60 watts doesn't really sound a lot in the bass world, but this guy packs one hell of a punch through a beautifully engineered 10-inch speaker. The AAA series are pretty much defined to be from the home, well, from the house to the stage. And I believe this is the smallest one they do. with a DI out. 60 watts doesn't sound a lot in bass terms, but this guy packs one hell of a punch. It's super simple to use. Ashdowns make some of the best bass amps on the planet. That's why PMT stocks so many of them. And there's a couple more in my list of six best cheap bass amps. Solely because they've been only making bass amps for 485 years, haven't they? Other amps like Orange do guitar amps, Fender make Strats and T-shirts, Ashdown, only bass amps. And the AAA 6010T is a simple little powerhouse, a bit like myself. Input, there's two, high and low, whether you've got an active bass or a passive bass. Just next to the input gain, which in this demo is halfway up because I think it works quite well with this room and this lovely Aston Stealth. Three band EQ and an output volume. There's a valve emulated drive in it, which is controlled by a little switch and obviously a dial to control how much drive you want. Headphone output, line in, balance DI out. Like I say, you run this into the desk so it can come through your monitors and into the crowd. It also features the AppTech technology, where you can plug in your phone and make it have effects in and delays and modulations and all that. I'm gonna do that here though, because I've been talking too much, and I'm gonna let you hear it with a few different EQ settings. And it has an 8 ohm external output on the back, so you can make it into a muckle monster, even though it's a tiny monster. So this with the EQ, flat, totally flat. The volume, input gain, and output volume are flat. With Ashdown as well, I know you can use the AppTech app to make effects happen within it, but these amps take pedals so well because they're such a clean, sterile, in the best possible way sound. It's perfect to be manipulated with, well, Ashdown's pedals as well. Ashdown just started making great effects pedals. Use one of them, they're great. So let's put the treble up, middle up, bass down. See what that sounds like. Definitely more of a pick thing. Bass up, treble and middle back slightly. I'm aware this video is more talking than bass playing, but there's only so much I can show you about this simple amp, which sounds so good. You've got to come into a PMT store and try it out for yourself. Let's put some of that drive in now. Perfect, want to get your Lemmy on. So that was the drive halfway up and all the way up. I hope this is coming across okay on camera because YouTube have got a horrible habit of compressing everything. But yeah, that's the short and sweet demo of the Ashdown AAA 60T. 60 stands for 60 watts, 10. It's got a 10 inch trigger at the front, pushes a lot of air for such a small, lightweight, punchy little bugger. What's your favorite Ashdown? Who's your favorite Ashdown user? I think mine's probably either Geezer or Sharvo from System. I had a good chat with Sharvo at NAMM. If you haven't seen that yet, check it out on the PMT of UK page. This is the Orange Crush Bass 50. Now, I've already got a video somewhere in the depths of the PNT for UK YouTube channel, and we're talking about the 100 watt. This is its little brother, the 50 watt. They also do a 25, which is dainty and cute. But I really enjoy this one solely because of the price. It's not the most expensive thing in the world, and I've seen a lot of people do small gigs with these. You can't really gig the 25. The 100's great for gigging with, but it's very loud. I've seen people gig with these, man. They're bloody awesome things. 50 watts. What I love about Orange is they always have a really lovely warm sound. Not things that like Fenders and Ashdowns aren't warm. You just get a unique warmthness, like when all the EQs set at noon. It's just a nice little, it's like the bass is giving you a hug, but it doesn't with what we'll get into later, which involves a blender. Anyways, this guy, 50 watts, all analog. That's what I love about Orange. Everything's analog, probably why it's so warm. Totally analog circuitry, no digitization. It's all from the fingers, through wires, to your lovely audience's ears. Top panel, very, very simple. It starts with a headphone input, which I always put the jack into first. And the amount of Oranges I think are broken by me going, it's not working. And then it's on the right-hand side, the input jack is. So who out there does that as well? Let me know down below. Volume control, four-band EQ, well, three-band EQ, and one of the knobs is a frequency knob, which shifts where the mid sits so that you're altering more towards the high end or the low end. We'll have a little fiddle with that in a bit. To the right of that is where it gets interesting. The gain and blend controls. These have loads of gain in, which is awesome. But sometimes it can be a little bit overbearing. So the blend control, which is lovely, lovely and stylized as a blender, you can blend in the clean channel, like. So your clean channel remains the same. We'll get to that more in a minute. But the overdrive channel kind of goes alongside it and doesn't make it too mucky. Blends all the way up, full on balls out distortion. It's great. There's also effects loop on the back and a switch for the blend control. So without further ado, this is the Orange Crush Bass 50. There, but it's fine. Let's play that MIDI control now, because this thing sounds great, EQ'd all the way up, it's the obvious. Bit more treble. That sounds really good, doesn't it? That with a bit of bass would sound very Ampeg SVT-ish. The EQ on this is so sensitive. It's what, like, the bass. Treble as well. Like Pino Palladino kind of. I can't do his thumb thing. Very talented and very tall. So the mid. Mid frequency and the mid control are both at noon now. Let's put the mid frequency up towards the higher end. So this is 3 o'clock if you're looking at a clock. And turn the mid up and down. Whereas if the frequency was at the bottom. I hope this is coming across okay on YouTube, because like I keep saying, YouTube compresses everything, and I highly recommend coming into your local PMT store and trying it out for yourself, because it's great. I hope me explaining it has just been enough. If not, it's a great amp, and don't let the decision of buying it be based on that. Blend control. This is halfway gain, halfway blend. Blend core over the way up. Gain core the way up, but blend halfway. Now let's put the gain all the way up, because I'm here and I can, and do this. Blends 10 o'clock. Blends at 1 o'clock. Mm-hmm. Sounds bloody awesome. But it's crazy. Very crazy amplifier. I forgot to mention one of the most important factors of this as well, is there's a built-in tuner on the top. I got far too carried away with talk about how analog and how beautiful this thing is. But there's a tuner on the top, which is great for bass. A lot of tuners in amps kind of suck for bass. This one certainly does. It's been designed specifically by Mr. Aid Emsley at Orange to be great for bass. There's also a pad if you're using electric basses, active pickup basses, so it doesn't blow the speaker out the front of this lovely orange or black cabinet. Who's your favorite orange bass player artist out there these days? There's so many. Last one I saw was a Fleetwood Mac guy. What's he called again? From Fleetwood Mac. What's he called, Alex? Bass player, Fleetwood Mac. It's not Christine McVie. Oh, wait, no. What's he called? Bass player from Fleetwood Mac has a tower of the new Tiny Terra Bass 500s. So, so cool. Check out that picture online. This guy was based off the OB-1 and the 4-stroke, not the Terra Bass, so it's got a bit more balls behind it. It's fantastic. Go into your local PMT store, try one out. Not only do they look good, they sound good. This is one of the smallest, loudest, lightest, most versatile little amps I've seen in an awfully long time. This is the Ashdown AAA 100BT. It's 100 watts, has a 12-inch speaker out front, packs a lot of power, and with it only being 100 watts, you can have it nice and quiet in your house, practice without blowing your windows out, but when you're on a gig with it, it'll push enough power out the front. Also has a DI in the top, so you can DI it into the sound system of the venue. This does so much. And it's also Bluetooth equipped. What does BT stand for? There's a lot of bass playing buskers out there, and this would be absolutely perfect. You can jam in the house, stream your songs through it, through your phone, it's extremely clear. Ashdown makes some great little home stereo units as well that sounds like 500 quid speakers and they're not a lot of money. This is well under 500 quid, by the way. As with everything Ashdown, it's punchy as hell and very simple to use. On the left, two inputs for high and low impedance instruments. Next to an input gain control and a little blue flashing light to show you that your Bluetooth has been connected. Right at that is a valve emulated gain circuit with an on-off switch and a variable, well, a knob to show how much gain you want. 3-band EQ, auxiliary in or Bluetooth volume, so when you're playing along with your tracks, and an overall massive volume. Right at that, headphone, output, auxiliary in if you want to Bluetooth it in and just go old school and use an aux cable, just next to the DI. On the back, there's a speaker output where you can also two switches to mute the speaker and the tweeter. It's awesome. This is how the 100 watt Ashdown AAA, I think it's called Access All Areas because they do a lot, sounds. What I've said before about these Ashdown AAAs is that they pack a lot of punch and are very clear sounding. Sterile in a good way. These guys take pedals super well. Also features the AppTech control input where you can get download an app from on your phone, plug it in and play some effects through this amplifier. Put reverb, modulation, delays on. It'll all come through this while playing along or jamming along with your tunes or someone else's tunes. It's fantastic. But with this being so lovely and clean sounding, it takes pedals pretty much like nothing else. It's really, really good. So that's the gain, that's EQ all totally flat. Let's just bump it up a little bit to show you what it's got. I always start these videos with everything at noon. And when you pump everything up to about 1 o'clock, I think that's where everything kind of, it's a little bit more of everything. Let's have some fun with the drive now. So, drive's in. Let's say they drive all the way up. Well, let's not go crazy yet. Let's go to 1 o'clock. And all the way up because I can. If a bass amp makes it pull a face, that means it's good. I was given it all, oh yeah! Great sounding amp, very versatile with the Aptec feature, with the fact that it's Bluetooth, with the fact that it's lightweight and very powerful, and not a lot of money. There's not many things which can compete with the Ashdown AAA 100 BT. This is the Blackstar Unity 60 bass combo. Blackstar are relatively new to the whole bass thing. They've been making great electric amps for years, and it's quite funny, when these were starting to get talked about, I never heard anything from Blackstar. It was always other brands going, do you hear Blackstar's making a bass amp? Blackstar making, no way. It's gonna be crap. They've never made anything like that before. They brought them out, blew everyone away, because they're absolutely great. They're very, very versatile. 30 watts to 500 watts. This is the 60 watt with a, yes, 10 inch speaker out front. They're versatile, not in the sense that you can Bluetooth your phone to them and jam along, or alter things with an app, or, I don't know, go into internal menus and turn things on or off. It's very analog almost on the top. Lots of switches and knobs. Input gain on the left, 3-band EQ, the frequency control, which kind of alters which area of the mid you're shifting with the mid control, and a master volume. Below that though is what makes it versatile. There's three overall sounds: classic, modern, and overdrive. Classic is what you heard there. Nice classic bass sound. Modern, bit more headroom. And overdrive, self-explanatory. So it's very versatile in that sense. There's also a built-in chorus, which sounds amazing, but I'll save that as a treat later on, and built-in compression, which I'm using on all the time now because I think bass sounds great with compression. It's awesome. So that's without it. And if I make a mistake and miss a note, you won't hear it, but if I do compression, then I'll make everything sound the same. So everything's at noon on the classic sound. The input gain is halfway up. The master volume is about 2. It says in the top, the classic is a valve-inspired preamp with vintage EQ section for thunderous bottom end and mid growl, and it certainly does that. Play the same thing, but on the modern. Thank you. You know, I think I preferred the classic, but after playing it then, I really enjoy that modern. It says the modern is high headroom with a punchy dynamics and advanced EQ with extended top end shaping. Awesome. Great, back to modern, classic. You do get a lovely smoothness with that modern sound though. That's awesome, let's try modern with the chorus. There's no depth and rate controls with the chorus, but it's set amazing from the factory. So this is great for in the house, because it sounds great at low volumes, but when you push it, it sounds even better. You could totally gig with this guy when it's absolutely pumping. It might not be loud enough for the crowd here, but on the back, it's got a balanced DI out, either in XLR or jack form with a ground lift. So you can have this blasting at the crowd through the PA speakers and have this as your onstage volume. Also on the back, there's a foot switch to turn all the lovely effects on and off. And also a speaker output where it's one of Blackstar speakers. You can use the power, an external speaker through the special XLR witchcraft on the back. So you can have a stack of these, man, all linked together and blow all your bass playing friends out of the way. I've been beating around the bush though. Let's hear that overdrive sound. I forgot the chorus is on, that's a pleasant surprise. Let's hit the chorus off now. Turn the gain 3/4 of the way up. Just a little bit up. This is quarter of the way up. And I think, ladies and gents, that's all I've got to say and play with the Blackstar Unity 60. It's a fantastic little amp. Let me know if you've got a Blackstar already out there in the comments, because like I said, these guys took the world by storm with how versatile, lightweight, powerful, and attractive they are. It's a beautiful little thing. And like I say, you can run it into the DI, run it out of the DI into a sound system, or plug it into one of the Blackstar external speakers and blow everyone's heads off. Oh, this is a good sounding bass amp. This is the Ashdown C110-250. 250 watts, 1x10, and exclusive to PMT. With it being exclusive, there's a limited number of these beautiful green-faced buggers available. It's like British Racing Green. It's so good. Ashdown's a British company, Rule Britannia and all that. It sounds as good as it looks. It's a classic Ashdown. Nice, clunky, warm, big, awesome. I seriously can't stress enough, you have to come to a PMT store and try this out for yourself. It's under 300 quid, it packs a lot of punch. There's a DI out on the front, but this is loud enough to gig with, man. 250 watts. Whew. 3-band EQ, a bright switch, a deep switch and an EQ button which switches on these two inner EQs, so it's technically a 5-band EQ. There's a valve emulated overdrive, built-in compression, and a built-in subharmonic, which kind of gives it a, it's like a lower octave. Input volume, output volume, effects loop, and you get one of the cool VU meters. Yeah, just sit and play, how much you can make it redline. Fantastic little amplifier, like I say, under 300 quid, and exclusive to PMT. And this is how she sounds. I'm gonna keep the bright and the deep switch in for this entire video because it just gives it more. It gives it a lot more. I do enjoy putting Ashdowns all to 1 o'clock as well. Because it just kinda... So this is without that inner EQ. There we go, look at that VU meter fly! Such a beautiful sounding, clunky in the best possible way amp. It's a classic Ashdown, man. Classic Ashdown. Compression, everyone loves a bit of compression. What compression does is compresses the signal so the lower notes are amplified and the notes that are a bit higher are lowified. So everything comes out with the same volume and nothing's clipping or too quiet. Overdrive, let's have some fun with that valve emulated overdrive. Awesome. Subharmonics. So, a lot of bass. A lot of versatility, a lot of handsomeness, and you get a VU meter, and you can only get it from PMT. This Ashdown's amazing. It's a little bit bigger than some of its brothers, like the AAAs and whatnot, but you get a little bit more. It takes away, there's not as versatile as having all the app control and all the effects you can put on it. It's just a great solid bass tone, which I think steps the bar up from the other ones. So there we have it, guys. Those are six of what I believe to be the best cheap bass amps out there that don't suck. Like I said, it's not all bedroom or stage. It's kind of a little mix in between. What have I missed out, though? Please let me know down below what amps I've missed. I love knowing what amps I've missed because I haven't always got access to everything, but I grab what I have and what I think will be good. And I think all of these are great. Let me know if you already have one or if this is making you want to buy something new down in that lovely comment section below. Give it a like if you enjoyed this video and enjoy me rambling on very quickly. I just try to play as much as I could. I don't like talking too much about these things. They're fantastic. If you want any more information on any of the amps I spoke about tonight, an Aston Stealth or the new Classic Vibe Squire range, go to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding beautiful PMT stores. There's got to be one near you. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a follow and a like to see lots of pictures of these amps, but with nice filters on them. I've been Dagan, and I shall see you next time. Oh!